Attacks by the Yemeni Houthi militant group on ships in the Red Sea are forcing freight firms to reroute in order to avoid the Suez Canal. This video was released by the Houthis on November 20th, showing armed men dropping from a helicopter and seizing a cargo ship in the southern Red Sea. The latest attacks came Monday, when the Houthis said drones were launched against two cargo vessels in the area. The Iran-aligned Houthi said the attacks are a response to Israel's assault on the Gaza Strip, which Israel launched after the October 7 rampage by Hamas militants. The situation has prompted the United States and its allies to discuss a task force that would protect Red Sea routes, something Iran has warned would be a mistake. In Israel on Monday, U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin said no group or state should test America's resolve.
In the Red Sea, we're leading a multinational maritime task force to uphold the bedrock principle of freedom of navigation. Iran's support for Houthi attacks on commercial vessels must stop.
The attacks have showed the ability of Middle Eastern paramilitary forces backed by Iran to upset global trade. Several major freight companies have begun sailing around Africa due to the danger, and there are signs the crisis is broadening to include energy shipments. The rerouting adds costs and delays, which industry analysts expect to be compounded over the coming weeks. While freight rates will likely increase on the longer voyages, the head of global freight platform Freighto said it is unlikely that rates will spike to the level seen during the pandemic. About 15% of world traffic transits via the Suez Canal, the shortest shipping route between Europe and Asia.